हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द प्राइमरी मैकेनिज्म दैट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्लेटलेट प्लग एंड अ सेकेंडरी मैकेनिज्म दैट इज ब्लड कोएगुलेशन और हेमियोस्टेसिस। व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ इंजरी टू द ब्लड वेसल, दिस टू मैकेनिज्म्स ऑपरेट एंड क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड और कोएगुलेशन ऑफ ब्लड टेक्स प्लेस। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द ड्रग्स which are acting on clotting time of blood. Certain drugs which are going to prolong the coagulation time of blood, while certain drugs which are going to study, that is, they are going to promote the coagulation of blood. First topic, that is coagulants. These are the drugs which promote coagulation of bloods are called as coagulants. Coagulants काय करतात? They promote coagulation of blood. Coagulation of blood means in first year in HAP practical, you have done the practical of clotting time of blood. This clotting time of blood, it is going to be decreased if coagulant drugs are given. Means, for example, if in a human being the clotting time of blood is 3 minutes and if coagulant drugs are given, for example thrombin is given, then from 3 minutes this clotting time is going to decrease to 2 minutes or less than 2 minutes. That is the coagulants. Means काय करतात? Coagulation of blood ही जी mechanism आहे ती mechanism काय करणार? ते increase करणार आहे. जेवढ्या लवकर coagulant drug दिल्यानंतर कोएगुलेशन जी प्रोसेस आहे ती कोएगुलेशन प्रोसेस इंक्रीज होणार आहे, त्याच्यामुळे लवकर ब्लड कोएगुलेट होईल. देअरफॉर वी से दॅट द ड्रग्स विच प्रमोट कोएगुलेशन ऑफ ब्लड आर कॉल्ड ॲज कोएगुलंट्स. दे आर यूज इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ हिमोरेज और ब्लीडिंग. एक्झाम्पल्स थ्रोम्बिन, मिनाडायॉन एक्सेट्रा. Now, for your syllabus, you have one of the drug that is dried thrombin. Dried thrombin source, it is prepared or it is obtained from the blood of human beings by a suitable fraction technique. The prothrombin fraction, which is present in the blood, that is going to be separated. Then in that, there will be addition of calcium ions, thromboplastin, and this prothrombin, which has been separated from the blood, it is converted into thrombin, and by filtration method of sterilization, it is going to be sterilized, and after that it is freeze dried. Source काय? सगळ्यात सुरुवातीला whole human blood collect केले जातं. Fractional technique ने जे prothrombin present आहे blood मध्ये ते separate केले जातं. त्या prothrombin मध्ये there is an addition of thromboplastin as well as there is addition of calcium ions, and this prothrombin is converted into thrombin. It is sterilized by filtration method and freeze dried and stored into suitable containers. Properties: it is a cream colored powder. It is soluble in normal saline solution, which gives a pale yellow solution. It may look like a cloudy. Stability storage condition: it is affected by light, air and heat. It should be stored under vacuum or in an atmosphere of nitrogen in sterile containers which are sealed for excluding microorganisms and moisture. The sealed containers are kept at temperature 2 to 8 degrees Celsius and protected from light. Now, stability storage condition of thrombin is important from your exam point of view, which is repeatedly asked in your exams for 2 marks. Give the stability storage condition of dried thrombin or thrombin. It is very simple. It is affected by air, light and heat. Therefore, you have to store thrombin under a vacuum or in an atmosphere of nitrogen. Container should be sterile one. It should be sealed properly therefore there should not be entry of microorganisms and moisture. The containers are kept at a temperature between 2 to 8 degrees Celsius and it should be protected from light. In an atmosphere of nitrogen means thrombin javas me container madhe pack kartat. Ta container madhe there is a presence of your nitrogen gas so that it will not get affected by moisture and microorganisms. That is called as in an atmosphere of nitrogen. Uses as a coagulant, it is topically used to control minor bleeding due to superficial cuts and injuries. Orally, it is used to prevent internal bleeding, for example, gastrointestinal bleeding. It is also used in combination with fibrin foam or gelatin sponge to prevent extensive or inaccessible hemorrhage. Now, fibrin foam or gelatin sponge, it is a substance which is prepared from fibrinogen and thrombin from the human blood plasma. Brand names, thrombostat, that is the trade name or brand name. See, I have given you the figures, example. This is your fibrin foam and this is your gelatin sponge. Both of them are prepared from fibrinogen and thrombin from the human blood plasma. Now, second drug which is acting as a coagulant, that is minadione. If you see this structure properly, you will see that this is the structure of 1,4-naphthoquinone. The basic structure, that is at first and at fourth position, there is a presence of your carbonyl group. Therefore, it is 1,4-naphthoquinone. And if you give the numbering, then you will see that at second position, there is a presence of your methyl group. Therefore, the chemical name will be 2-methyl-1,4-naphthoquinone. So this is your chemical name. Dusra position la methyl group present, therefore I have written 2-methyl. At first and fourth position, the carbonyl group is present, therefore I have given the positions 1,4 and the basic structure, that is of naphthoquinone, therefore 1,4-naphthoquinone. This is your chemical name of minadione. Properties, it is pale yellow crystalline powder. Characteristic odor and a bitter taste. It is freely soluble in chloroform, soluble in ether, sparingly soluble in alcohol, practically insoluble in water. Stability storage, it decomposes on exposure to light, therefore stored in well-closed light-resistant containers. Uses as a coagulant in treatment of hemorrhages, in vitamin K deficiency disorders, to overcome toxicity or overdose of anticoagulants. Minadione ke teen uses hai, you can use as a coagulant in treatment of hemorrhage or bleeding. It is also your vitamin K, therefore in deficiency disorders it can be used. It is obtained by synthetic method, we have seen in the previous lecture. And whenever a patient is on anticoagulant therapy and if there is overdose of your anticoagulant or toxicity takes place, to overcome that you can use the drug, that is minadione. Official preparation, minadione tablet IP, minadione injection, which is official in your Indian pharmacopoeia. Brand names, Pernivit, Systomate, Systocet, Amicin, these are your trade names or brand names of minadione. Here we complete the first topic, that is coagulants. means the drugs which is going to promote or help in coagulation of blood, used in treatment of hemorrhage, example dried thrombin, minadione, etc. And two drugs for your study, that is thrombin and minadione, stability storage condition and structure of minadione is very important for your exam point of view. Now the second topic, that is anticoagulants. I have already told you, whenever the word anti comes, always remember that these are the drugs which are going to produce opposite action as that of coagulants, or which is going to oppose. Now here coagulant means which help in coagulation of blood. Opposite kya hasil, they are going to delay or prolong the coagulation time of blood are known as anticoagulants. The drugs which delay or prolong the coagulation time of blood and they are going to prevent coagulation are known as anticoagulants. Example, heparin, warfarin sodium, bishydroxycumarin, phenindione, etc. These are your anticoagulant drugs. Anticoagulant drugs are used in treatment of venous thrombosis. Now, first of all, what is the meaning of thrombosis? You have already studied in first year. Thrombosis means formation of a blood clot inside a blood vessels which is obstructing the flow of blood through the circulatory system, that we referred as thrombosis. Thrombosis manje kay ki aplya shariramade ja blood vessels present hai tya blood vessels madhe blood clot tayar hoto jachyamule circulatory system madun jo flow of blood hai that is going to be affected. Now meaning of venous thrombosis. Venous thrombosis means formation of a blood clot within a vein, that we referred as venous thrombosis. Javis ekhadya vein madhe blood clot tayar hoto tyala mhanto apan venous thrombosis. Example, deep vein thrombosis, formation of blood clot in the veins in legs, that we called is that deep vein thrombosis. Pulmonary embolism. Now embolism means it is a blockage causing piece of material inside a blood vessel. Embolism manje kay, thrombosis process madhe je blood clot tayar zale tya place madhun jeva te detach hun it moves towards the lungs or it moves towards the pulmonary system, tala apan manto embolism. It is a blockage in one of the pulmonary arteries in your lungs. It is caused by blood clots that travel to the lungs from the legs or other parts of the body, and it is going to inhibit or it is going to affect flow of blood to the lungs, that we referred as pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary embolism manje kay ki aplya lungs madhe ja arteries present hai jala apan pulmonary arteries manto, je blood clot tumcha legs madhe tayar zalet kiwa shariracha dusra bhag madhe tayar zalet, that gets detached and they move towards your lungs, that we referred as pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary embolism mule jo lungs la blood flow hai, that blood flow it is going to be affected. In that condition you can use anticoagulants. Cardiac infraction or cardiac arrest, or we call it as myocardial infraction. Myocardial infraction, it occurs when blood flow decreases or stops to a part of the heart, causing damage to the heart muscles. Symptoms includes chest pain, difficulty in breath or shortness of breath, pain in arms and feet, Even you can experience heaviness in your arms and feet, etc. मायोकार्डियल इन्फ्रॅक्शन किंवा कार्डियक इन्फ्रॅक्शन म्हणजे काय, की जे आपले हार्टचे जे मसल्स आहेत त्या हार्टच्या मसल्सला जर प्रॉपर ब्लड सप्लाय किंवा ब्लड फ्लो जर नसेल तर त्यावेळेस हार्टचे मसल्स जे काय होतात ते स्टार्ट डॅमेजिंग और डेथ ऑफ द सेल्स ऑफ द कार्डियक मसल्स टेक्स प्लेस. दॅट वी कंडिशन वी कॉल्ड एज कार्डियक इन्फ्रॅक्शन. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड टू प्रिव्हेंट थ्रोम्बोसिस आफ्टर सर्जरी, to prevent clotting of blood during blood transfusions, preservation and storage of blood, hemodialysis, etc. That means anticoagulant drugs used in treatment of venous thrombosis, pulmonary embolism, cardiac infarction, it is used to prevent clotting or coagulation of blood during blood transfusions, preservation and storage of blood in blood banks, to prevent thrombosis after operation, etc. Anticoagulant drugs are act at various stages of process of coagulation. They act at plate aggregation stage, they act at fibrin or clot formation stage, they act at thrombin formation stage. जे आपण anticoagulant drugs देतो ते anticoagulant drugs काय करतात की प्रोथ्रोम्बिनचं थ्रोम्बिन मध्ये ज्यावेळेस कन्वर्जन होतं ही जी मेकॅनिझम आहे किंवा ही जी स्टेप आहे दॅट इज गोइंग टू बी डिलेड और इनहिबिटेड बाय युअर anticoagulants. सेकंड मेकॅनिझम आहे की जे फायब्रिनोजेन मॉलिक्युलचे जे स्प्लिट होऊन जे स्मॉल पेप्टाइड ज्याला आपण फायब्रिन म्हणतो जे काही तयार होतात ती जी स्टेप आहे किंवा ती जी स्टेज आहे दॅट स्टेज सम अँटीकॉग्युलंट्स आर ऍक्टिंग ऑन दॅट स्टेज. सम ऑफ द ड्रग्स आर ऍक्टिंग ऍट प्लेट ऍग्रिगेशन स्टेज दॅट इज प्लेट प्लेट इंटरॅक्शन स्टेज. दिस आर युअर अँटीकॉग्युलंट्स. क्लासिफिकेशन, फर्स्ट वन डायरेक्ट ऍक्टिंग अँटीकॉग्युलंट्स आर गिव्हन बाय पॅरेंटल रूट देअरफॉर नोन ऍज पॅरेंटल अँटीकॉग्युलंट्स, एक्झाम्पल हिपॅरिन. सेकंड क्लास indirect acting anticoagulants given by oral route of administration, example cumarin derivatives. In indirect acting, depending upon chemical laws, there are two subclasses. First one, cumarin derivatives, example bishydroxycumarin, warfarin sodium. Second one, indendione derivatives, example diphenendione, phenendione, etc. This is the classification of anticoagulants. The first class that is given by parenteral route or direct acting, example heparin. Second class given by indirect means given by oral route, therefore we call it as indirect acting. Two subclasses, cumarin derivatives, indendione derivatives, example of cumarin, bishydroxy cumarin, warfarin sodium. Indendione derivatives, example diphenendione, phenendione, anisendione, etc. These are the examples of your anticoagulants. There are two drugs for means sorry there are total three drugs for your study. One is heparin, second bishydroxycumarin, and third that is warfarin sodium. These are the three drugs for your syllabus. Now remember that I have already told you that whenever you are writing the classification in your notebooks, at that time the drugs which are for your syllabus, underline them so that you can easily remember them, and in examination if their drugs are asked you can easily write down their uses, etc. In the similar way, if the structure of a drug it is for your study, along with the underline you have to do a star in front of it so that it becomes very easier to remember the basic structure and the chemical class of your drug. First drug, heparin. Source, it is obtained from lungs of ox or intestinal mucosa of pig or sheep. It is a mucopolysaccharide. is composed of D-glucosamine and D-glycuronic acid units linked through an oxygen bridge. Properties: it is white or creamy white powder, hygroscopic in nature, it is freely soluble in water. Stability storage condition: now it is affected by light as well as it is hygroscopic in nature. Aqueous solutions are stable if a pH of the solution is maintained between 7 to 8 and stored at a temperature 25 degrees Celsius, then heparin is very stable. But if there is slightly change in the pH of the solution, or if you store at a temperature more than 25 degrees Celsius, it becomes unstable. It should be stored in airtight containers which are sealed to exclude the entry of microorganisms and moisture, and should be protected. That is the stability storage of heparin. Same way as the stability storage of thrombin is important, in the same way, stability storage condition of heparin is also important. Then the next one, that is uses. It is used to treat deep arterial and venous thrombosis and pulmonary embolism. I have already explained you what is venous thrombosis and pulmonary embolism. For prevention of thrombosis during hemodialysis, blood transfusion, open heart surgery, vascular surgery, etc. अपन हिपेरिन जनरली कभी यूज करतो कि जावेस आर्टरियल की और वेनस थ्रोम्बोसिस कंडीशन है, पल्मोनरी एम्बोलिज्म है, कि वह जावेस अपन हेमियोडायलिसिस करतो, ब्लड ट्रांसपोर्ट करतो, कि ओपन हार्ट सर्जरी करतो, टू प्रिवेंट थ्रोम्बोसिस, वी कैन यूज इट. ऑफिशियल प्रिपरेशन हिपेरिन इंजेक्शन विच इज ऑफिशियल इन योर आईपी एंड बीपी. ब्रांड नेम्स: हिप जेल, बीपेरिन जेल, Thrombofov ointment, etc. These are your trade names or brand names. Then the second, that is cumarin derivatives. This is the structure of cumarin. If you see the structure properly, the benzene ring, this is your benzene ring. This benzene ring has been fused with the structure of alpha pyron ring. Benzene ring has been fused with the structure of alpha pyron ring, and in combined it is the structure of your cumarin. This cumarin drugs are obtained by synthetic matter as well as they can be found naturally also. From this two drugs, one is warfarin sodium. Properties: it is white crystalline powder, odorless, and a slight bitter taste. It is very soluble in water, freely soluble in alcohol, very slightly soluble in chloroform. Stability storage: it is affected by air and light, therefore stored in tightly closed light resistant containers. Uses: for prevention and treatment of vein thrombosis, pulmonary embolism, to prevent myocardial infarction, to prevent arterial and venous thrombosis, for prevention of thrombosis during and after vascular surgery, open heart surgery, etc. Official preparation: warfarin sodium tablet IP, warfarin potassium tablet BP. Official preparation: univarfarin, warf, cumadin, sofarin, etc. Second drug, bishydroxycumarin. Properties: it is a white or creamy white crystalline powder, faint pleasant odor, a slightly bitter taste, slightly soluble in chloroform, soluble in solutions of alkali hydroxides, practically insoluble in water. Stability storage: affected by air and light, and stored in tightly closed light resistant containers. Use this same as that of your warfarin sodium. Official preparation, bis hydroxy cumarin or dicumarol tablet USP. Brand names, dicumarol, dicumol, dufalon, etc. These are the trade names of bis hydroxy cumarin. Now, cumarin derivatives, I have shown you the structure. Same way, this is the structure of your indandiene derivatives. If you see the structure properly, you will see that the benzene ring, this is your benzene ring, it has been fused with the structure of cyclopentane at first and third position. Carbonyl group is present, therefore the name of this ring becomes 1,3 indandiene derivatives. Both of them, that is oral hypoglycemic drugs, act by reducing synthesis of prothrombin. लिवर मध्ये विटॅमिन के मुळे जे प्रोथ्रोम्बिनचं बायोसिंथेसिस होतं, दॅट बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ प्रोथ्रोम्बिन इज इनहिबिटेड बाय क्युमारिन्स अँड इंडेंडायोन डेरिवेटिव्स. दे ऑल्सो इनहिबिट द ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ विटॅमिन के बाय इनहिबिटिंग कार्बोक्सिलेशन ऑफ ग्लुटामिक ऍसिड इन द लिवर. अँड इन द सेम वे your heparin, that is an anticoagulant given by parenteral route of administration, inhibits the conversion of prothrombin to thrombin, therefore produces a antithromboplastin effect. It also, to a lesser extent, heparin interferes with aggregation of platelets induced by thrombin. These are the mechanism of actions of your heparin, that is parenteral route of administration, and oral anticoagulants, cumarin derivatives and indandiene derivatives. In today's lecture, we have studied or we have covered two topics. First one was anticoagulants, in that we have studied thrombin and minandione. Second topic, anticoagulants, in that we have seen the meaning, classification, and three drugs, heparin, bis hydroxy cumarin and warfarin sodium. Here we complete your topic, that is coagulants and anticoagulants. Thank you.